What are those numbers you hear during your gum exam at the dentist?
3, 2, 2.
This is called periodontal charting, or perio charting, or taking probings, or the gum check. It's considered standard of care to have these numbers taken routinely. So let me give you a brief overview of what kind of numbers you want to hear and what all the numbers mean in general. So to check the health of your gums, bone, and surrounding tissue, we use an instrument called a periodontal probe. It's similar to a ruler, it measures in millimeters. There's a natural space between your gums and your tooth, which should be between 1 and 3 millimeters. So healthy gums are 1 or 2 or 3 millimeters, all within normal limits. Those numbers are considered healthy. That's a healthy gingival sulcus. Now, if you hear the number 4, don't freak out. It generally indicates inflammation or puffy red gums. And any area with a 4 is generally an area for you to focus on at home. Whether it's brushing, flossing, water picking, using interdental brushes, or all of the above, the dental provider taking the probing measurements will help you determine how concerning your area of a 4 millimeter pocket actually is. But again, generally a 4 millimeter reading can be reversible, and with proper oral hygiene can sometimes even go back down to a 3 if you reduce the gingival inflammation, aka the area of gingivitis, this 4. Now, if you hear a number 5 or greater, sometimes it may be inflammation still, but oftentimes it can indicate an area of bone loss. The bone is what holds your teeth in place, right? So when we find these areas of 5 millimeters and above, it's considered a perio pocket. We have found an area of gingival concern, possibly periodontal disease, also known as gum disease. Again, your dental provider will talk to you about your individual case, because maybe sometimes there's only one area of a 5 millimeter localized pocket, which we are keeping clean and keeping on watch. But sometimes there can be 5, 6, 7 millimeter pockets all throughout the mouth, which in this case can indicate that a deeper cleaning may be necessary, or a more frequent recare period. For more information on that, you can see my video all about deep cleanings, SRPs. The link is below this video in the bottom bar, as well as my What's the Difference Between Plaque and Tartar video that is also linked below. Because once we find a perio pocket, the next question is there plaque or tartar hiding inside this perio pocket? So both these videos, the deep cleaning one and the What's the Difference Between Plaque and Tartar, will help you understand those concepts a little more. But for the purpose of this video, in all, the point of perio charting is to determine the health of the gums, the bone, and the surrounding tissues. Really quick last thing, recession is not what I'm talking about in this video. It's a whole different numbering system, although recession can be related to gum disease. That's a whole nother video for a whole nother day. I just wanted to say that really quick because lots of patients get these two things confused. So I'll make a separate video all about recession soon. Until then, peace, love, and teeth. I'm sitting with my legs crossed on a stool, so it's not really easy to do my normal, like, fall out, but I'm gonna do it.